أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear student السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Dear student Today we will revise doping and purification of silicon of inorganic material chemistry course code CAM 3115 doping and purification of silicon the key concepts of this topic are silicon properties fluorovim why doping needed P-type doping and N-type doping, electronic band structure in doped semiconductors, P-N junction and different methods for the manufacturing of hyperpure silicon, included metallurgical grade silicon, ferrosilicon, electronic grade silicon, purification of silicon, zone refining, high speed zone refining, and purification process. Now we start from silicon properties. Silicon is a chemical element with symbol SI and atomic number 14, a hard and brittle crystalline solid with a blue-gray metallic luster. It is a tetravalent metalloid. It is a member of group 14 in the periodic table. Along with carbon above it and germanium 10, lead and fluorovim below. It is not very reactive, although more reactive than germanium and has great chemical affinity for oxygen. It was first purified and characterized in 1823 by Johannes Jacob Berzelius. Silicon is the eighth most common element in the universe by mass, but very rarely occur as the pure element in the earth crust. And now, what is metalloid and fluorovim? Metalloid are chemical element with properties intermediate between those of typical metals and non-metal. And what is fluorovim? It is a super heavy artificial chemical element with symbol Fl and atomic number 114. It is an extremely radioactive synthetic element. The element is named after the Flerov Laboratory of Nuclear Reactions of the Joint Institute for Nuclear Research in Dubna, Russia, where the element was discovered in 1998. What is doping? The process of adding substances to a pure semiconductor for the purposes of modeling its electrical properties is known as doping. It is a process of adding some impurity atoms in the semiconductor. Doping means the introduction of impurities into a semiconductor crystal to the defined modification of conductivity. Doping means the introduction of impurities into a crystal. For example, silicon can be doped with boron and phosphorus. Boron is trivalent, mean three valence electron, and it forms p-type of semiconductor. Phosphorus is pentavalent, mean 5 valence electron, and it forms n-type of semiconductor. These impurity atoms are known as dopants. After addition of these dopants, some of the properties of the conductor can be changed according to our need. This is the schematic diagram of n-type semiconductor, and this is the schematic diagram of p-type semiconductor. In n-type semiconductor, conduction band is partially filled. And we dope with phosphorus. And in p-type, conduction band unfilled. And we dope silicon with aluminium. In n-type, an outer electron more than the silicon atom, while in p-type an outer electron less than the silicon atom. Why doping needed? Semiconductors are intrinsic in nature. That is, number of electron and hole are equal. It is only when we dope a semiconductor, the electron or hole become majority. The one that become majority are responsible for flow of current. So, if you do not dope a semiconductor, there would not be any significant current flow. Doping means the introduction of impurities into a semiconductor crystal to the defined modification of conductivity. Two of the most important material, silicon, can be doped with are boron, which is 3 valent, mean it has 3 valence electron, and other phosphorus, which is pentavalent, mean 5 valence electron. Other material are aluminium, indium, these are 3 valent, and arsenic, antimony, these are 5 valent. The dopant is integrated into the lattice structure of the semiconductor crystal. The number of outer electron define the type of doping. Element with 3 valence electron are used for p-type doping, while 5 valued element for n-type doping. And now, n-type doping. The 5 valent dopant has an outer electron more than the silicon atoms. The outer 4 electron combine with ever one silicon atom, while the 5th electron is free to move and serve as charge carrier. This free electron requires much less energy to be lifted from the valence band into the conduction band than the electron which caused the intrinsic conductivity of silicon. The dopant which meet an electron is known as an electron donor. The dopants are positively charged by the loss of negative charge carriers and are built into the lattice. Only the negative electron can move. Doped semi-metal whose conductivity is based on free electron are n-type or n-doped. Due to the heavier number of free electron, whose are also named as majority charge carriers, while free mobile holes are named as the majority charge carriers. Arsenic is used as an alternative to phosphorus because its diffusion coefficient is lower. This means that the dopant diffusion during subsequent processes is less than that of phosphorus, and thus the arsenic remains at the position where it was introduced into the lattice originally. And what is diffusion coefficient? The quantity of a substance that in diffusing from one region to another passes through each other. Each unit of cross section per unit of time when the volume concentration gradient is unity. The whole picture of n-type semiconductor is shown in this diagram. And now p-type doping. In contrast to the free electron due to doping with phosphorus, the 3 valent dopant effect is exactly the opposite. The 3 valent dopant can catch an additional outer electron, thus leaving a hole in the valence band of silicon atoms. Therefore, the electron in the valence band become mobile. The holes move in the opposite direction to the movement of the electron. The necessary energy to lift an electron into the energy level of indium as the dopant is only 1% of the energy which is needed to rise a valence electron of silicon into the conduction band. With the inclusion of an electron, the dopant is negatively charged. Such dopants are called acceptor. Again, the dopant is fixed in the crystal lattice. Only the positive charge can move. Due to positive hole, these semiconductors are called p-conductive or p-dop. Analog to n-dop semiconductor, the holes are the majority charge carriers. Free electron are the minority charge carriers. And this is a pictorial diagram of p-doped semiconductor. Doped semiconductors are electrically neutral. The terms N and p-type doped do only refer to the majority charge carriers. Each positive or negative charge carrier belongs to a fixed negative or positive charge dopant. And now electronic band structure in doped semiconductor. By the introduction of a dopant with 5 outer electron in n-doped semiconductor, there is an electron in the crystal which is not bound and therefore can be moved with relatively little energy into the conduction band. Thus, in n-doped semiconductor, the donor energy level is close to the conduction band edge. The band gap to overcome is very small. Analog, through introduction of a 3-valent dopant in a semiconductor, a hole is available which may be already occupied at lower energy by an electron from the valence band of the silicon. For p-doped semiconductor, the acceptor energy level is close to the valence band as shown in the following diagram of N semiconductor and P semiconductor. And what is P junction? When we place P type and N-type semiconductor in contact with one another, a p-n junction is formed as shown in this diagram. P-n junctions are basic component of most common electrical devices. While semiconductor doped with either n-type dopant or p-type dopant are better conductors than intrinsic semiconductor, interesting properties emerge when P and N type semiconductor are combined to form a PN junction. Manufacturing of hyperpure silicon. The manufacturing of the hyperpure silicon for photovoltaic occurs in two stages. First, the oxygen is removed to produce metallurgical grade silicon. It is further refined to produce semiconductor grade silicon, an intermediate grade with impurity levels between metallurgical silicon and semiconductor grade silicon is often termed solar grade silicon. What is metallurgical grade silicon? Silica is the dioxide form of silicon and occurs naturally in the form of quartz. While beach sand is also largely quartz, the most common raw material for electronic grade is high purity quartz rock. Ideally, the silica has low concentration of iron, aluminium, and other metals. The silica is reduced, mean we remove oxygen through our reaction with carbon in the form of coal, charcoal, and heating to 1500 to 2000 degree in an electrode arc furnace. Silicon dioxide react with carbon and we get silicon, as shown in this equation. The resulting silicon is metallurgical grade silicon. It is 98% pure and is used extensively in the metallurgical industry. The transition metal in the silicon result in deep level in the band gap and the high recombination activity make metallurgical grade silicon unsuitable for use in electronics. In addition, boron and phosphorus dopant impurities are much too high in concentration, mean greater than 50 to 100 ppm, to allow suitable compensation procedures. Ferrosilicon, that is 98 to 99% pure silicon. An even greater production of silicon is in the form of ferrosilicon that is manufactured using a similar process to that described above, but is done in the presence of iron. Ferrosilicon is used extensively in metals manufacture. It is 98 to 99% pure with the major contamination of carbon, alkali earth and transition metals, and hundreds of ppm of boron and phosphorus. What is ppm? Ppm is part per millions. 1 ppm is equal to 1000 ppb and 1 milligram per kg is equal to 1 ppm. And what is charcoal? Charcoal is the lightweight black carbon and ash residue hydrocarbon. And now electronic grade silicon, same process. A small amount of the metallurgical grade silicon is further refined for the semiconductor industry. Powdered metallurgical grade silicon is reacted with anhydrous hydrochloric acid at 300 degree in a fluidized bead reactor to form silicon trichlorohydride. During this reaction, impurities such as iron, aluminium and boron react to form their halides. The silicon trichlorohydride has a low boiling point of 31.8 degree and distillation is used to purify the silicon trichlorohydride from the impurity halides. The resulting silicon trichlorohydride now has electrically active impurities such as aluminium, phosphorus, boron, iron, copper, or gold of less than 1 ppb. Finally, the pure silicon trichlorohydride is reacted with hydrogen at 1100 degree for approximately 200 to 300 hours to produce a very pure form of silicon. The reaction takes place inside large vacuum chamber and the silicon is deposited onto thin polysilicon rod, small grain size silicon, to produce high purity polysilicon rod of diameter 150 to 200 millimeter. The procedure was first developed by Siemen, the 60, and is often referred to as the Siemen process. Now we will discuss purification of silicons. Silicon is always found contaminated or in impure form for different purposes, such as its use in industry as silicon chips or in doping process. Silicon should be purified to pure form. Silicon is purified by the following processes. First, zone refining, which is also known as zone melting, floating zone process, or traveling melting zone. A purification technique for crystalline substances in which a heating system passes slowly over a bar of the material to be refined, creating a molten region that carries impurities with it across the bar. A technique for the purification of a crystalline material, and especially a metal in which a molten region travels through the material to be refined, pick up impurities at its advancing edge, and then allows the purified part to recrystallize at its opposite edge. This method is particularly used when metals are required in high degree of purity. It is based on the principle that when an impure metal in a molten state is allowed to cool, only the metal crystallizes. While the impurities remain present in the molten state or melt, zone refining is a process in which organic and inorganic compounds are purified. Like distillation and gas and liquid chromatography, zone refining is dependent on the distribution of material between two phases. However, the distribution in zone refining is between the solid and liquid phases, while the distribution in distillation and gas chromatography is between the liquid and vapor phases. When a homogeneous liquid mixture is cooled, the composition of the solid that crystallizes out is usually different from that of the liquid. The purification of substance by zone refining relies on this difference. Zone refining was developed in 1952 by William J. Fenn at the Metallurgical Research Department of Bell Telephone Laboratories to purify material used in the semiconductor industry. Fenn found that by passing a molten zone down a rod of silicon or germanium, he could cause the impurities to remove. in the direction of the molten zone. Repeating this process multiple times reduces the impurities in the main part of the rod to a few parts per billion and then concentrate them at the end of the rod as shown in this diagram. High speed zone refining. While used successfully to purify organic chemical, zone refining is time consuming. Purification takes days. The mini zone high speed zone refiner from Design Scientific reduces that time to hours. It concentrates the impurities in a sample or purifies chemical with purity of 99.999% or higher. The compact instrument can purify 1 to 20 gram of sample at a time. Control include melt temperature, freeze temperature and zone migration rate. Any thermally stable sample that is solid between minus 10 degree and plus 300 degree can be purified by this method. Purification process. In zone refining, a short melt zone travels slowly through an elongated sample of a crystalline material. A molten zone traversing a solid sample has two liquid-solid interfaces, a melting interface and a freezing interface. At the melting interface, the composition does not change. At the freezing interface, the impurities favor the liquid phase because the crystal structure tend to exclude molecules that do not fit into the crystal lattice. And this is the diagram of purification process. Passing the molten zone through the sample many times, concentrate the impurities at one end, leaving the opposite end highly purified. The impure metal converted into a rod, which is heated at one end with the circular heater. A narrow zone of metal is melted. The heater is slowly moved along the rod. The pure metal recrystallizes out of melt while the impurities remain in the melt, which moves along with the melted zone of the rod with the movement of heater. The process is repeated several times. The end of rod where impurities have collected is cut off. The method is employed for the purification of germanium, silicon, gallium, etc., which are used in semiconductor. Student, these are assignments. First, what is doping and why it is needed? Differentiate between N and P doping with suitable diagrams. And the second one is write a brief note on metallurgical and semiconductor grade silicon. Dear student, if you have any question, you can send me your question 24/7 at my email ID mAslamChemist@hotmail.com. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.